I'm Michael Ossmann of Great Scott Gadgets with a first look at HackRF Pro. HackRF Pro is our latest software-defined radio platform designed to receive or transmit radio signals from 100 kHz all the way up to 6 GHz. This is a prototype in a 3D printed enclosure. The final enclosure will look very similar to the enclosure for HackRF Pro's predecessor, HackRF One. HackRF Pro will seem quite familiar to you if you've used HackRF One, other than a new label. The main difference you'll notice when you unbox HackRF Pro is that it has a Type-C USB connector instead of the micro USB connector that was used on HackRF One. The reason it looks so similar to HackRF One is that we designed HackRF Pro to be backward compatible with HackRF One. It's even compatible with most third-party hardware add-ons and enclosures. The most likely incompatibility you might encounter is that an enclosure designed for HackRF One may need its opening for the USB connector widened a little bit for the new Type-C connector. Inside the enclosure is a printed circuit board with about 460 individual components, 50% more components than HackRF One. We found a way to improve almost every aspect of the HackRF design while maintaining the same underlying architecture to maximize compatibility. Let's try the first thing I always do with a new software-defined radio platform, receiving broadcast FM. First, let's see what the FM broadcast band looks like in my neighborhood using HackRF One. I'm using GQRX to tune to 100 MHz. So the HackRF is tuned to 100 MHz, which is roughly in the center of the FM broadcast band, and you can see several radio stations in the spectrum. If I tune around to different frequencies, in theory we should be able to listen to these stations. And, well, this one looks like it should be strong enough to pick up, but I'm not getting anything. And that's going to be the case with most of these, except maybe the very most powerful ones. And the reason this isn't working is because of this DC spike that I have in the middle. The DC spike actually represents a little bit of a blind spot that is very common. You'll see this spike in the received spectrum for a number of different software-defined radio receivers. And if we subtract that spike, if we remove it in software, we hide that defect without actually removing the blind spot. So it can still interfere with some modulations even if we've removed it. So a better solution, in my opinion, in most cases, is to use software to select a different frequency like this, rather than using the hardware to tune to a different frequency. We leave the HackRF tuned to a center frequency of 100 MHz, and that allows it to capture all of these different radio stations at once, and then in software we select a different frequency. There are some other spikes, like this one, or this one here at about 97.6, which actually seems to have a little bit of modulation. I think there's actually an FM radio station underneath it that I'm having a hard time picking up because it's interfered with by this signal. Some of these radio stations down around 96 MHz are real radio stations, like this one, but some of them act like this one. It's actually an image of this station here. It's a mirror image, and there's another one probably here that is a mirror image of this one. So my strongest signals actually are appearing, mirror images of them are appearing in the other side of the spectrum, which could interfere with other radio stations that I'm trying to pick up around 96 MHz. Now you'll see other images like that from those strongest stations appear if I adjust the gain too high. If I adjust the gain, I'm pretty close to optimal gain setting to start with, but if I adjust higher, you'll see a whole bunch of other peaks appear because I'm distorting those strongest signals, and we're ending up with a bunch of different images of those
powerful radio stations appearing at all sorts of different frequencies. If I set the gains too low, then most of the signals that we can pick up go away. The optimal setting is somewhere up here. Now let's try the same thing with HackRF Pro. In GQRX, I can select a different device, and as you can see, it looks like I have two HackRF Ones with two different serial numbers. One of these is, in fact, HackRF Pro. In the future, we'll make it easy for developers of software like GQRX to distinguish between HackRF Pro and HackRF One, but in this demo, I'm deliberately using a slightly older version of GQRX to show you what happens if you're using older software that supports HackRF One, but is not yet aware of HackRF Pro. In a case like this, you should be able to use your HackRF Pro because it will just appear to the software as a HackRF One. So I'll select this other HackRF and start receiving at 100 MHz. And one thing you might notice right away is that the signal levels seem very hot. We have higher power signals. I need to turn the gain down. Even if I turn the gain down all the way, I can still see a few of the stronger radio stations. And my optimal gain settings are a little bit higher than that, but generally lower than I had with HackRF One. Another thing you might notice is that I don't have a DC spike. Right here at 100 MHz, there is no DC spike, so I'm hearing some static instead of hearing the silent spike. And I should be able to tune around just by changing my center frequency to a different radio station, like I tried to do with HackRF One unsuccessfully, or I can use the method of just selecting a station in software, which is usually what I prefer to do anyway. I may even be able to pick up this station I was interested in at 97.5, which with the HackRF One was very difficult to pick up because there was a spur almost right on top of it. With HackRF Pro, I do need to turn up my gain a little bit because the station is pretty weak, but I can pick it up better than I could with HackRF One. And I can even pick up some other stations that I may not have been able to select with HackRF One, some of these more distant stations that are weaker are a little bit easier to find and pick up. I have, in general, with HackRF Pro, I have fewer spurs, lower power spurs, better signal-to-noise ratio, and also fewer unwanted images. Something you might notice is that I don't see those mirror images here. At 96 MHz, I don't see the mirror images of these stronger stations at 104 MHz. So the signals that I'm seeing and hearing are real radio stations. I'm seeing fewer of those phantom signals and more real signals.
Thank you for watching. Like all our projects at Great Scott Gadgets, HackRF Pro is open source. As we move closer to shipping HackRF Pro in September, we'll release more demos and more technical details, including the complete hardware design and software under an open source license. We couldn't do the open source work that we do without support from the community. Thank you.